This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Astatine is a radioactive chemical element with the chemical symbol at an atomic number 85, and is the rarest naturally occurring element on the Earth's crust. It occurs on Earth as the decay product of various heavier elements. All its isotopes are short-lived. The most stable is astatine-210, with a half-life of 81 hours. Elemental astatine has never been viewed because any macroscopic sample would be immediately vaporized by its radioactive heating. It has yet to be determined if this obstacle could be overcome with sufficient cooling. The bulk properties of astatine are not known with any certainty. Many of these have been estimated based on its periodic table position as a heavier analog of iodine, and a member of the halogens, the group of elements including fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. It is likely to have a dark or lustrous appearance and may be a semiconductor or possibly a metal. It probably has a higher melting point than that of iodine chemically. Several anionic species of astatine are known, and most of its compounds resemble those of iodine. It also shows some metallic behavior, including being able to form a stable monatomic cation in aqueous solution, unlike the lighter halogens. Dale R. Corson, Kenneth Ross McKenzie, and Emilio G. Segre synthesized the element at the University of California, Berkeley in 1940, naming it after the Greek astatos astatos. Unstable 4 isotopes of astatine were subsequently found in nature, although it is the least abundant of all the naturally occurring elements, with much less than 1 gram being present at any given time in the Earth's crust. Neither the most stable isotope astatine-210 nor the medically useful astatine-211 occurs naturally. They can only be produced synthetically, usually by bombarding bismuth-209 with alpha particles. Contents 1 characteristics 11 physical 12 chemical 2 compounds 3 history 4 isotopes 5 natural occurrence 6 synthesis 61 formation 62 separation methods 621 dry 622 wet 7 uses and precautions 8 see also. 9 notes 10 references 11 bibliography 12 external links. Characteristics: astatine is an extremely radioactive element. All its isotopes have short half-lives of 81 hours or less, decaying into bismuth, polonium, radon, or other astatine isotopes. Most of its isotopes are very unstable with half-lives of 1 second or less. Of the first 101 elements in the periodic table, only francium is less stable. The bulk properties of astatine are not known with any certainty. Research is limited by its short half-life, which prevents the creation of weighable quantities. A visible piece of astatine would immediately vaporize itself because of the heat generated by its intense radioactivity. It remains to be seen if, with sufficient cooling, a macroscopic quantity of astatine could be deposited as a thin film. Astatine is usually classified as either a nonmetal or a metalloid. Metal formation has also been predicted. Physical: most of the physical properties of astatine have been estimated by interpolation or extrapolation, using theoretically or empirically derived methods. For example, halogens get darker with increasing atomic weight. Never been observed, while other sources assert or imply its existence despite this controversy. Many properties of diatomic astatine have been predicted. For example, its bond length would be 300 plus or minus 10 pm, dissociation energy 837 plus or minus 125 kJ mol minus 1, and heat of vaporization increment HVAP 5439 kJ mol minus 1. The latter figure means that astatine may at least be metallic in the liquid state on the basis that elements with a heat of vaporization greater than approximately 42 kJ mol minus 1 are metallic when liquid. Diatomic iodine, with a value of 4,171 kJ mol minus 1, falls just short of the threshold figure. Chemical: the chemistry of astatine is clouded by the extremely low concentrations at which astatine experiments have been conducted, and the possibility of reactions with impurities, walls and filters, or radioactivity byproducts, and other unwanted nanoscale interactions. Many of its apparent chemical properties have been observed using tracer studies on extremely dilute astatine solutions, typically less than 10^-10 mols L-1. Some properties state most of the organic chemistry of astatine is, however, analogous to that of iodine. Astatine has an electronegativity of 22 on the revised Pauling scale. Palladium, silver, thallium, and lead. Some characteristic properties of silver and sodium astatide, and the other hypothetical alkali and alkaline earth astatides, have been estimated by extrapolation from other metal halides. Hydrogen astatide space filling model: the formation of an astatine compound with hydrogen. 2. An otto in aqueous solution, formed by the reaction of astatine with an oxidant such as elemental bromine or in the last case by sodium persulfate in a solution of perchloric acid. The well-characterized otto -3 anion can be obtained by, for example, the oxidation of astatine with potassium hypochlorite in a solution of potassium hydroxide preparation of lanthanum triastatinate LOTO 33, following the oxidation of astatine by a hot sodium sulfide O8 solution, has been reported further oxidation of otto -3, such as by xenon difluoride in a hot alkaline solution or pyriodate in a neutral or alkaline solution, yields the peristatate ion otto -4. This is only stable in neutral or alkaline solutions. Astatine is also thought to be capable of forming cations in salts with oxyanions such as iodate or dichromate. This is based on the observation that, in acidic solutions, monovalent or intermediate positive states of astatine coprecipitate with the insoluble salts of metal cations such as silvery iodate or thallium dichromate. Astatine may form bonds to the other chalcogens. These include S7At and ATCSN-2 with sulfur, a coordination selenoria compound with selenium, and an astatine tellurium colloid with tellurium structure of astatine monoiodide, one of the astatine interhalogens and the heaviest known. Diatomic interhalogen astatine is known to react with its lighter homologs iodine, bromine, and chlorine in the vapor state. These reactions produce diatomic interhalogen compounds with formulas ATI, astatine monobromide, and astatine monochloride. The first two compounds may also be produced in water. Speculatively attributed to the extreme reactivity of such compounds, including the reaction of an initially formed fluoride with the walls of the glass container to form a non-volatile product thus, although the synthesis of an astatine fluoride is thought to be possible, it may require a liquid halogen fluoride solvent, as has already been used for the characterization of radon fluoride. History: Mendeleev's table of 1871, with an empty space at the eca iodine position in 1869, when Dmitri Mendeleev published his periodic table, the space under iodine was empty. After Niels Bohr established the physical basis of the classification of chemical elements, it was suggested that the fifth halogen belonged there before its officially recognized discovery. It was called eca iodine from Sanskrit eka. Allison's method and the validity of his discovery. There was another claim in 1937, by the chemist Rajendralal de working in Dhaka in British India, now Dhaka in Bangladesh. He chose the name Dakin for element 85, which he claimed to have isolated as the thorium series equivalent of radium F polonium 210 in the radium series. The properties he reported for Dakin do not correspond to those of astatine. Moreover, astatine is not found in the thorium series, and the true identity of Dakin is not known. In 1936, a team of Romanian physicist Horia Halube and French physicist Yvette Cauchois claimed to have discovered element 85 via X-ray analysis. In 1939, they published another paper which supported and extended previous data. In 1944, Halube published a summary of data he had obtained up to that time, claiming it was supported by the work of other researchers. He chose the name Dor, presumably from the Romanian for longing, as World War II had started 5 years earlier, as Halube was writing in French, a language which does not accommodate the "-ine" suffix. Dor would likely have been rendered in English as Dorini, had it been adopted in 1947. Halube's claim was effectively rejected by the Austrian chemist Friedrich Paneth, who would later chair the IUPAC committee responsible for recognition of new elements. Even though Halube's samples did contain astatine, his means to detect it were too weak, by current standards, to enable correct identification. He had also been involved in an earlier false claim as to the discovery of element 87 francium, and this is thought to have caused other researchers to downplay his work. Emilio Segre, one of the discoverers of astatine in 1940, the Swiss chemist Walter Minder announced the discovery of element 85 as the beta decay product of radium A polonium 218, choosing the name Helvetium from Helvetia, Switzerland. Karlich and Bernert were unsuccessful in reproducing his experiments, and subsequently attributed Minder's results to contamination of his radon stream. Radon 222 is the parent isotope of polonium 218. In 1942, Minder, in collaboration with the English scientist Alice Lee Smith, announced the discovery of another isotope of element 85, presumed to be the product of thorium, a polonium 216 beta decay. They named this substance Anglo-Helvetium, but Karlich and Bernert were again unable to reproduce these results. Later in 1940, Dale R. Corson, Kenneth Ross Mackenzie, and Emilio Segre isolated the element at the University of California, Berkeley, instead of searching for the element in nature. structure, the scientists created it by bombarding bismuth 209 with alpha particles in a cyclotron particle accelerator to produce, after emission of two neutrons, astatine 211. The discoverers, however, did not immediately suggest a name for the element. This was because an element created synthetically at the moment was not seen as a completely valid one, created in invisible quantities and not yet discovered in nature. In addition, chemists were reluctant to recognize radioactive isotopes as legitimately as stable ones. In 1943, astatine was found as a product of two naturally occurring decay chains by Berta Karlich and Trod Bernhardt, first in the so-called uranium series, and then in the actinium series. Since then, astatine has been determined in a third decay chain, the neptunium series. Friedrich Paneth in 1946 called to finally recognize synthetic elements, quoting, among other reasons, recent confirmation of their natural occurrence, and proposed the discoverers of the newly discovered unnamed elements name these elements. In early 1947, Nature published discoverers' suggestions. A letter from Corson, Mackenzie, and Segre suggested the name astatine, coming from the Greek astatos, astatos meaning unstable, because of its propensity for radioactive decay, with the ending ine found in the names of the four previously discovered halogens. The name was also chosen to continue the tradition of the four stable halogens, where the name referred to a property of the element. Corson and his colleagues classified astatine as a metal on the basis of its analytical chemistry. Subsequent investigators reported iodine-like, cationic, or amphoteric behavior in a 2003 retrospective. Corson wrote that some of the properties are similar to iodine. It also exhibits metallic properties, more like its metallic neighbors Po and Bi isotopes. Main article, Isotopes of Astatine Alpha Decay Characteristics for Sample Astatine Isotopes. Mass Number Mass Excess Half-Life Probability of Alpha Decay. Alpha Decay Half-Life 207-30117877826789-13243. 208-30117997213500883-0-12491. 7 quintillion 1 quadrillion 418 trillion 9 billion 999 million 900,000 spade suit 418% 7 quintillion 4 quadrillion 619 trillion 200 billion spade suit 172. 6 quintillion 988 quadrillion 166 trillion 578 billion 289 million 353,390 spade suit 10,397. Astatine's alpha decay energies follow the same trend as for other heavy elements. Lighter astatine isotopes have quite high energies of alpha decay, which become lower as the nuclei become heavier. Astatine 211 has a significantly higher energy than the previous isotope, because it has a nucleus with 126 neutrons, and 126 is a magic number corresponding to a filled neutron shell, despite having a similar half-life to the previous isotope 81. Emitter polonium 210. In total, only 5 isotopes have half-lives exceeding 1 hour. Astatine 207 to minus 211. The least stable ground state isotope is astatine 213, with a half-life of 125 nanoseconds. It undergoes alpha decay to the extremely long-lived bismuth 209. Astatine has 24 known nuclear isomers, which are nuclei with one or more nucleons, protons or neutrons in an excited state. A nuclear isomer may also be called a metastate, meaning the system has more internal energy than the ground state, the state with the lowest possible internal energy, making the former likely to decay into the latter. There may be more than one isomer for each isotope. The most stable of these nuclear isomers is astatine 202M1, which has a half-life of about 3 minutes, longer than those of all the ground states bar those of isotopes 203-211 and 220. The least stable is astatine 214M1, its half-life of 265 nanoseconds is shorter than those of all ground states except that of astatine 213 natural occurrence neptunium series, showing the decay products, including astatine 217, formed from neptunium 237. Astatine is the rarest naturally occurring element. The total amount of astatine in the Earth's crust quoted mass 236 times 1025 grams is estimated to be less than 1 gram at any given time. Any astatine present at the formation of the Earth has long since disappeared. The four naturally occurring isotopes astatine 215, -217, -218 and -219 are instead continuously produced as a result of the decay of radioactive thorium and uranium ores, and trace quantities of neptunium-237, the landmass of North and South America combined, to a depth of 16 kilometers 10 miles, contains only about 1 trillion astatine-215 atoms at any given time. Around 35 × 10⁻¹⁰ grams astatine-217 is produced via the radioactive decay of neptunium-237, primordial remnants of the latter isotope, due to its relatively short half-life of 214 million years, are no longer present on Earth. However, trace amounts occur naturally as a product of transmutation reactions in uranium ores. Astatine-218 was the first astatine isotope discovered in nature. Astatine-219, with a half-life of 56 seconds, is the longest-lived of the naturally occurring isotopes. Isotopes of astatine are sometimes not listed as naturally occurring because of misconceptions that there are no such isotopes, or discrepancies in the literature. Astatine-216 has been counted as a naturally occurring isotope, but reports of its observation which were described as doubtful have not been confirmed. Synthesis formation possible reactions after bombarding bismuth-209 with alpha particles. Reaction energy of alpha particle 209-83/42 He 211-85 at 2-1-0-26 MeV 209-83/42 He 210-85 at 3-1-0-40 MeV 209-83/42 He 209-85 at 4-1-0-6-0 MeV. Astatine was first produced by bombarding bismuth-209 with energetic alpha particles, and this is still the major route used to create the relatively long-lived isotopes astatine-209 through astatine-211. Astatine is only produced in minuscule quantities, with modern techniques allowing production runs of up to 66. Maximum energy of the particle accelerator is set to a value optimally 2917. Methanol or chloroform astatine yields of up to around 80% may be achieved. Dry separation is the method most commonly used to produce a chemically useful form of astatine. Wet the bismuth or sometimes bismuth trioxide target is dissolved in, for example, concentrated nitric or perchloric acid. Astatine is extracted using an organic solvent such as butyl or isopropyl ether, or thiosaminicarbazide. A separation yield of 93% using nitric acid has been reported, falling to 72% by the time purification procedures were completed. Distillation of nitric acid, purging residual nitrogen oxides, and redissolving bismuth nitrate to enable liquid-liquid extraction. Wet methods involve multiple radioactivity handling steps and are not well suited for isolating larger quantities of astatine. They can enable the production of astatine in a specific oxidation state and may have greater applicability in experimental radiochemistry. Uses and precautions. Several 211 at containing molecules and their experimental uses. Agent applications. Astatine tellurium colloids. Compartmental tumors. 6-ASTATO-2-methyl-1,4-naphthoquinyl-diphosphate adenocarcinomas. 211 at labeled methylene blue melanomas. Meta-astatobenzyl guanidine neuroendocrine tumors. 5-ASTATO-2-deoxyuridine various. 211 at labeled biotin conjugates various pretargeting. 211 at labeled octreotide somatostatin receptor. 211 at labeled monoclonal antibodies and fragments various. 211 at labeled bisphosphonates bone metastasis. Newly formed astatine 211 is the subject of ongoing research in nuclear medicine. It must be used quickly as it decays with a half-life of 72. Permit multi-step labeling strategies. Astatine 211 has potential for targeted alpha particle radiotherapy, since it decays either via emission of an alpha particle to bismuth 207, or via electron capture to an extremely short-lived nuclide, polonium 211, which undergoes further alpha decay. Polonium X-rays emitted as a result of the electron capture branch, in the range of 77 to 92 keV, enable the tracking of astatine in animals and patients. Although astatine 210 has a slightly longer half-life, it is wholly unsuitable because it decays to the extremely toxic polonium-210. The principal medicinal difference between astatine-211 and iodine-131, a radioactive iodine isotope also used in medicine, is that iodine-131 emits high-energy beta particles, and astatine does not. Beta particles have much greater penetrating power through tissues than do the much heavier alpha particles. An average alpha particle released by astatine-211 can travel up to 70. P. Durbin, Human Radiation Studies, Remembering the Early Years, 1995. Several obstacles have been encountered in the development of astatine-based radiopharmaceuticals for cancer treatment. World War II delayed research for close to a decade. Results of early experiments indicated that a cancer-selective carrier would need to be developed, and it was not until the 1970s that monoclonal antibodies became available for this purpose. Unlike iodine, astatine shows a tendency to dehalogenate from molecular carriers such as these, particularly at sp3 carbon sites, less so from sp2 sites. Given the toxicity of astatine accumulated and retained in the body, this emphasized the need to ensure it remained attached to its host molecule. While astatine carriers that are slowly metabolized can be assessed for their efficacy, more rapidly metabolized carriers remain a significant obstacle to the evaluation of astatine in nuclear medicine. Mitigating the effects of astatine-induced radiolysis of labeling chemistry and carrier molecules is another area requiring further development. A practical application for astatine as a cancer treatment would potentially be suitable for a staggering number of patients. Production of astatine in the quantities that would be required remains an issue. Animal studies show that astatine, similarly to iodine, although to a lesser extent, is preferentially concentrated in the thyroid gland. Unlike iodine, astatine also shows a tendency to be taken up by the lungs and spleen, possibly because of in-body oxidation of it too. At if administered in the form of a radioalkaloid, it tends to concentrate in the liver. Experiments in rats and monkeys suggest that astatine 211 causes much greater damage to the thyroid gland than does iodine 131, with repetitive injection of the nuclide resulting in necrosis and cell dysplasia within the gland. Early research suggested that injection of astatine into female rodents caused morphological changes in breast tissue. This conclusion remained controversial for many years. General agreement was later reached that this was likely caused by the effect of breast tissue irradiation combined with hormonal changes due to irradiation of the ovaries. See also book, astatine book, period 6 elements book, halogens book, chemical elements sorted alphabetically book, chemical elements sorted by number, radiation protection chemistry portal notes. Carat, this half vaporization period grows to 16 hours if it is instead put on a gold or a platinum surface. This may be caused by poorly understood interactions between astatine and these noble metals. Carat, the extrapolated molar refractivity of diatomic astatine is 414 cc. Using the method given by Johnson, simple plot of the values for F, Cl, bridge and I versus the cube of their covalent radii. This indicates astatine may be a metal in its condensed state, based on the Goldhammer-Hersfeld criterion, which predicts metallic behavior if the ratio of molar refractivity to molar volume is 1:1. It is also possible that this is sorption on a cathode. Carat, the algorithm used to generate the Allred-Rocco scale fails in the case of hydrogen, providing a value that is close to that of oxygen 35. Hydrogen is instead assigned a value of 22. Despite this shortcoming, the Allred-Rocco scale has achieved a relatively high degree of acceptance. Carat, iodine can act as a carrier despite it reacting with astatine in water, because these reactions require iodide I-. Not only I2. Carat, an initial attempt to fluoridate astatine using chlorine trifluoride resulted in formation of a product which became stuck to the glass. Chlorine monofluoride, chlorine, and tetrafluorosilane were formed. The authors called the effect puzzling, admitting they had expected formation of a volatile fluoride 10 years later. The compound was predicted to be non-volatile, out of line with the other halogens but similar to radon fluoride. By this time, the latter had been shown to be ionic. Carat, in other words, some other substance was undergoing beta decay to a different end element, not polonium-218. Carat, in the table, under the words mass excess, the energy equivalents are given rather than the real mass excesses. Mass excess daughter stands for the energy equivalent of the mass excess sum of the daughter of the isotope and the alpha particle. Alpha decay half-life refers to the half-life if decay modes other than alpha are omitted. Carat, the value for mass excess of astatine 221 is calculated rather than measured. Carat, this means that, if decay modes other than alpha are omitted, then astatine 210 has an alpha decay half-life of 4,6286. One well-established meta-state, such as astatine -216 m. Other designation techniques are sometimes used. Carat, Emsley states that this title has been lost to berkelium, a few atoms of which can be produced in very highly concentrated uranium-bearing deposits. However, his assertion is not corroborated by any primary source. Carat, a nuclide is commonly denoted by a symbol of the chemical element this nuclide belongs to, preceded by a non-spaced superscript mass number and a subscript atomic number. number of the nuclide located directly under the mass number. Neutrons may be considered as nuclei with the atomic mass of 1 and the atomic charge of 0, with the symbol being N or omitted at all with the atomic number omitted. It is also sometimes used as a designation of an isotope of an element in isotope-related chemistry. See however Nagatsu et al. Who encapsulate the bismuth target in a thin aluminium foil and place it in a niobium holder capable of holding molten bismuth. See also Lavrukina and Pozniakov. In other words, where carbon's 1s atomic orbital and 3p orbitals hybridize to give 4 new orbitals shaped as intermediates between the original s and p orbitals. Unfortunately, the conundrum confronting the field is that commercial supply of 211 AT awaits the demonstration of clinical efficacy. However, the demonstration of clinical efficacy requires a reliable supply of 211 AT. References A.B. Corson, Mackenzie. Of astatine by laser ionization spectroscopy, Nature Communications 4:1-6 doi, 101,038, NCOMMS 2819 PMC. Jan, T.P. 2010 MIPS and their role in the exchange of metalloids 679 Springer p. Lavrukina. 103:1-9 doi, 101,007, BF02165358. Kugler. Smith, A., Arrett, W.F. 1960 College Chemistry Appleton Century Crofts p. doi, 101,007, BF02164864.